Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2205, Loan Survey Explosion. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelly. Now, just yesterday in episode 2204, it was Kaylee from Nashville who had to do a VLOOKUP explosion for every item here in column D. We had a matching bunch of items over in column G and needed to explode those. So if Palissy had eight items, we'd get eight rows. Today, we have Quentin. Now, Quentin was in my seminar in Atlanta, but he's actually from Florida. And Quentin has almost 1,000 customers over here, more than 1,000 customers in column A. And for every customer, he needs to create this survey of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 questions. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to add a sequence number just with the numbers 1 through 5, 6, 7. So that way I create a nice blank row in between. I'm going to make both of these data sets into a table. So we're trying to get these seven rows exploded for every one of those 1,000 customers. That's the goal. Now I could do this with VBA, I could do this with formulas, but it's kind of Power Query week here. We're on a run of this is our third Power Query example in a row. So I'm going to use Power Query. I'm going to make this left one into a table. I'm going to be very careful to name this, not table one. I'm going to give it a name. I have to reuse that name later, so I'm going to call it questions, like that. And then this will be table two. But I'm going to rename that to be customers. Not so important that I rename this one. It's the second one that has to be have the name. So we're going to choose this data, and we're going to say from a table or range, get and transform data. This is known as Power Query. It's built into Excel 2016. If you have 2010 or 2013 on Windows, not a Mac, not iOS, not Android, you can download Power Query for free from Microsoft. So we're going to get data from a table or range. There's our table. We're not going to do anything to it. Just close and load to, only create a connection. All right, and see the name of that query is questions. It uses the same name as here. And then we come back to this one. And data from a table or range. All right, so there's a list of our 1,000 or more customers. Hey, now, shout out to Miguel Escobar, my friend who's the co-author of M is for Data Monkey. I'll put a link to that in the video. Great book about Power Query who helped me with this. We're going to create a brand new custom column. And the custom column formula is this right here. Equal sign, hashtag, quote, the name of the query, end quote. All right. I never would have figured that out with Miguel. So thanks to Miguel for that. And when I click OK, yeah, it doesn't look like it worked, right? We just get table, table, table. But that's exactly what we had yesterday with Kaylee and the ticketing. And all I have to do is expand this. And I'm actually going to say I probably don't need the sequence. Well, let's put it in just in case. We can take it out after we see it. Right now we have 1,000 rows. And now we have 7,000 rows. Beautiful. I can see now that it's appearing in sequence, so I don't need that. I'll right-click and remove just that one column, and then I can home, close and load, and bam, we should now have more than 7,000 rows with seven questions, or six questions and a blank space for every customer. Quentin was thrilled with that one in the seminar. Cool, cool trick, avoids VBA, avoids a whole bunch of formulas using index and everything like that. Great way to go. But hey, today, let me send you out to M is for Data Monkey, Ken Poles and Miguel Escobar, the greatest book about Power Query. You'll love that book. In 2 hours, you'll become a pro with that book. All right, so wrap up today. Quentin needs to generate an identical survey for 1,000 different customers. There's 6 or 7 or 8 questions for each customer. Now, we could do this with VBA or macro, but since we're on a Power Query run here, let's do a Power Query. I added an extra blank question to the questions, added a sequence number to make sure that blank stays there. Made the customers into a table. Make the questions into a table. It's really important you name questions something that you can remember. I called mine questions. Add the questions to Power Query as a connection only. And then as you're adding the customers to Power Query, create a new custom column where the formula is hashtag quote the name of the first query end quote. And then expand that column in the Power Query editor. Close and load back to the spreadsheet. And you're done. An amazing trick. I love Power Query. Greatest thing to happen in Excel in 20 years. I want to thank Quentin for showing up in my seminar. He's been to my seminar a couple of times before. Great guy. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.